Welcome to the demonstration of functional annotation using BLAST2GO OmicsBox. OmicsBox is BioBump user-friendly all-in-one analysis software for NGS data. It performs four modules, namely genome analysis, transcriptomics, functional analysis, and metagenomics. BLAST2GO is one of the functional annotation tool in OmicsBox, establishing the annotations for functional genomic studies, especially non-model organism research. For downloading OmicsBox, search by text by clicking OmicsBox download, enter the first link. Here, you can download the latest version of OmicsBox. Once it is downloaded, proceed with the installation process. OmicsBox is a commercial application, so we can proceed with the 7-day free trial by clicking on the request trial and enter the necessary information. Once the activation is done, the activation key will be given through our mail. So once you open the OmicsBox wizard, a prompt window opens. Asking for the activation key, just paste your activation key here. Now, you can right away perform the bioinformatics analysis. I'm going to perform the functional annotation of pearl millet using OmicsBox. Pearl millet is the important crop in semi-arid tropics, which is well known for the adaptations in the drought condition, low soil fertility, and high temperature. So because of its tolerance to difficult growing conditions, it can be grown in areas where other cereal crops such as maize or wheat could not survive. So now the functional annotations. So it is the serial process of attaching the biological functions to the sequence of genes or the proteins. The first level is to retrieval of the sequence from database or the research articles. The next is finding the similarities using the alignment tools like BLAST. So after finding the similarities, attaching of biological information to the specific genes is the next step. And finally, the genes or the protein sequence with specific functions will obtain. So, the question why we have specifically chosen the pearl millet is, as mentioned before, BLAST2GO are highly popular in annotating novel sequences in non-model organism research. Since there is no available inbuilt genome browser for pearl millet, as if that have been provided for maize or rice, since I have chosen BLAST2GO toolbox for annotating. International Pearl Millet Genome Sequencing Consortium IPM-GSC in the year 2018 by ICRISAT have released the genome sequence that provides resources to improve agronomic traits arid environments. Our objective is to annotate the genes responsible for yield component traits and total carotenoid content in pearl millet. Six QTL regions were identified responsible for these traits. From the genome sequence resource, I have downloaded the GFF and PIP file. So GFF file holds the information describing the genes, and PIP file holds the protein sequences for all the identified genes from all chromosomes. Now, based on the gene ID given in the GFF file, the corresponding protein sequences were retrieved from the PIP file for our QTL regions. The extracted protein files will be our input file for the BLAST2GO annotation. This is the gene ID of our QTL regions extracted from the GFF file. And this is the protein sequences of the corresponding gene ID. So we have prepared the input file. Now we can proceed with the BLAST2GO annotation using the OmicsBox. Open the OmicsBox. Step 1 is to load our data. We have saved our input file in the FASTA format. Now go to File, Load Sequence, and Load FASTA file. And select your file containing the set of sequences in the FASTA format and give load. Once it is loaded, our input sequences are arranged based on the sequence name in the tab format. Now we have to proceed with the BLAST. Click on the functional analysis, go to BLAST and click run BLAST. So in the BLAST options, we have to select the database to proceed BLAST. Here, Cloud BLAST, it is the high performance, secure and cost optimized solution. It is independent from NCBI servers to provide fast and reliable sequence alignment. NCBI BLAST, it is an open source which allows searching molecular sequence database with BLAST algorithm. The main advantage is no database is required. And the local BLAST is we can search against our own database. We can also create own and search. Custom database Cloud BLAST is the user can run their BLAST against a database made of their own custom selected FASTA files. So here I'm going to use database as NCBI BLAST and give next. In the BLAST configuration page, email address is needed in case of NCBI BLAST. Enter the email ID. In the BLAST configuration dialog, select the type of BLAST mode, that is BLAST program, which is appropriate for our sequence. Since our sequence is the protein sequence, we are choosing BLAST P. And select the BLAST database as NR, that is non-redundant database. Here, the taxonomic filter, it is a search for BLAST results only in the selected taxonomy. So I'm not giving any taxonomy. So BLAST E value, it is a statistical significance threshold for reporting matches against a database sequence. If we increase the E value, it shows less stringent matches. So it is better to set the lower value. So we are giving the default value. The number of BLAST hits, it is the number of alignments we want to achieve. It is from 0 to 20, I am giving default as 20. And after entering the required information, click next. In the advanced configuration, the first is in the BLAST parameters, the word size, it is one of the important parameters. For a nucleotide sequence, it is 11 and for protein sequence, it is 3. If we increase the word size, it increases the search speed. But these are the standard values. So we are giving this default value. The low complexity filter, it filters the low complexity regions from protein sequence before executing a database search. It means these regions are differ from the compositions and complexity that is normally associated with globular structures. So in the filter options, high scoring segment pair, HSP length cutoff, it is a local alignment with no gaps that shares high level of similarity. And HSP hit coverage means how much query sequences is to cover. Finally, the result of the BLAST queries can be also be directly saved in, to a file in different format by selecting the corresponding destination. Here we can choose where to save our BLAST results and click run to start the BLAST. It usually takes more time. Once our BLAST analysis is finished, it shows orange color. Our next step is to proceed with the InterproScan. Go to functional analysis. Click on InterPro. So the InterproScan, it provides functional analysis of proteins by classifying them into families and predicting domains and important sites. To classify proteins in this way, InterPro uses predictive models known as signatures provided by several different databases. Cloud IPS, it is a cloud-based omics box community resource for fast analysis. EMBL EBI, it is a public web service. When we start run, our sequence are sent to EBI server. It starts scanning our sequence against the InterPro signature and results are depend on the EBI web server. So these configuration page show the database that we'll use to retrieve the protein families and domains, etc. So I'm giving EMBL EBI InterproScan and give next. Next. We can select the needed database or the sequence features individually and click next. Choose where to save our InterPro results. And run. The InterPro results are highlighted in the violet color once it is completed. InterPro scan can be run in parallel with the BLAST. The next step is mapping. Click on the functional analysis. Click BLAST2GO mapping and run geo mapping. Mapping, it is a process of retrieving geo terms associated with the hits obtained by the BLAST search. Here, based on the BLAST result accessions, it retrieves the gene names or IDs from the database. Click run. The mapped sequence will turn green. So once after mapping is finished, now proceed with the annotation. Click on functional analysis and go to BLAST2GO annotation, run annotation. Annotation, it is the process of selecting specific geo terms from the geo pool obtained by mapping step and assigning them to the query sequence. Geo annotation is carried out by applying an AR on the geo terms. In annotation, first it finds the highest hit similarity, then it do abstractions by setting the geo weight factors. So for geo terms, E value will be higher. The HSP hit coverage, it sets the minimum needed coverage between HIT and HSP. For example, if we set 80, the HSP would cover at least 80% of length from the hit. The evidence code weight, it promotes the assignments of annotations with the experience evidences. If we do not want this evidence code, we can set it to 1 and give next and click on run. Now the annotation results in a color change the sequence table to blue color. So this is the final result of the annotated sequence. It holds the identified geo names, geo IDs, enzyme names, enzyme codes, InterPro IDs and names of all the input sequences. We can view the statistics of our input sequence proceeded with the BLAST, InterPro, mapping and annotations. For that, click on the general tools and select tag statistics. So the chart tag distributions gives the number of sequences that has been blasted, number of sequences that has been undergone InterPro and the sequence that have been annotated and mapped. So we can save the this file by clicking on the save as option on the right corner of right corner toolbar. Next, we have to proceed with the geograph. Click on the functional analysis, select gene ontology graphs and give make geograph. The graph drawing configuration page, it specifies how to generate the geograph. It is based on geo ID or based on geo names. You can give either of your options and give run. So this is a simple geograph based on their geo names. Next, we have to proceed with the charts and graphs. Go to functional analysis. Click on charts and statistics. So we are going to create the charts for the annotation results. So click annotations and next. In the annotation statistics, proceed the following informations which you would need in the graphs. And click run. As the result, the annotation distributions for all the geo level distribution has been obtained. In the geo distribution by level, click on this chart and save the chart. So the chart describes the geo distribution, that is gene ontology distributions of sequences to the biological process, molecular functions and cellular component. Once all these results are obtained, save the result, go to file, click save. It saves the current BLAST2GO project as .vox file. So once after saving, we have to export these results. Go to file, give export. So the export allows to export the generated data in many different format. So we can export it in the table format or in the annotation format. I'm going to export in table format, that is in .txt table format. And click export. So it has been exported. We can view the table result in the Excel file. So this is the final result of the annotated file. So these results can be narrowed down for picking the candidate genes responsible for yield component traits and carotenoid content in the pearl millet.